When we think of Albert Einstein, we immediately think of his crazy hair. We also think of him as a one-of-a-kind genius that made many groundbreaking scientific discoveries, such as the famous equation E equals mc², among many others. In fact, he has made such a big legacy that we often use the word Einstein as a synonym for the word genius. However, did it really take an exceptional mastermind to discover what Einstein had contributed to humanity's knowledge? Before we begin, don't forget to subscribe for more interesting content. Click on the bell to be notified for brand new videos. To understand Einstein's true mental ability, it is important to realize what his life was like. When he was very little, nobody would have ever expected him to be a genius. In fact, very far from it. He wasn't able to talk until he was much older and didn't show any signs of genius early on. He threw numerous temper tantrums and his parents suspected him to have a learning disability. One may expect for him to at least be a straight-A student during his school years, but he actually did poorly and even decided to drop out at the age of 15. But something that was not obvious during Einstein's childhood was his never-ending thirst for self-learning. This idea can be seen scattered across Einstein's life. For example, at the age of 4, his father gave him a compass. He was absolutely obsessed with it to the point that he spent night after night observing the needle move. And at the age of 12, he produced his original proof of the famous Pythagorean theorem, an equation that most kids do not spend much time pondering about. In college, he even infuriated his professors by missing classes because he would rather study on his own. Even though other people may have viewed Einstein as a misbehaving student, taking a closer look at his lifestyle helps explain Einstein's persistent mindset towards learning, especially towards topics such as science and math. And with his success much later on in life and Nobel Prize-winning publications, you may be wondering how smart one had to be to discover concepts such as the theory of general relativity, the equation E equals mc², and a whole host of others. The short answer is that he supposedly had an IQ of 160, but that tells us very little about his brilliance. Because Einstein was never actually tested, that value is only an estimate, and it's very difficult to capture one's intelligence with just one number anyway. There are too many variables that go into play. So rather than trying to define his intelligence with a single number, we can try to make sense of it by exploring his impact within the scientific field. For instance, let's take into account what Einstein had to go through to develop his theory of general relativity, which took some 8 years between the years 1907 and 1915. To put this into perspective, imagine working on a very difficult physics problem. After several fruitless minutes or perhaps hours of thinking, one may give up and take a peek at the solutions. However, there was no answer key to explain the universe for Einstein. So he had to spend day after day, completely immersed in the world of physics and trying to explain the world with equations. And one day, he was looking out the window and wondering what it would be like to ride on a light beam. This creative insight gave him a spark of inspiration, and the rest is history. Unfortunately, he faced countless obstacles in the way when developing his theory. He stumbled across dead end after dead end, found errors in his calculations, and had to completely restart several times. Even his marriage was suffering, and there was literally a world war taking place around him. However, he was so determined to unlock the secret of the universe that he never stopped working and kept looking at the light at the end of the tunnel. And his determination paid off. 8 years after he first started working on his theory, he finally solved the mystery when he came across a solution that he had abandoned years before. Einstein was so shocked he had heart palpitations when he realized that his equation was correct. But for scientists to accept his theory, it had to be tested and proven that it was indeed true. This required investigating pictures of stars during a total solar eclipse. The closest one would take place 4 years after he had finalized his theory. That is exactly what a British man named Arthur Eddington decided to do in 1919. He traveled to the small island of Principe, located off the western coast of Africa. But sadly, the plan to photograph the solar eclipse was a complete failure due to cloudy skies. The quality of his pictures was too blurry to make an accurate conclusion to Einstein's theory. Following the unfortunate turn of events that year, many more decided traveled to Australia to capture photographs of the next solar eclipse 3 years later in 1922. One of the travelers was an American astronomer named William Wallace Campbell. He was one of the few people there who managed to get high-quality pictures of the solar eclipse. Over 90 stars were visible in Campbell's photograph. Upon returning to his lab and performing calculations, he officially announced the news, "Einstein is correct." Einstein's willingness to not only spend year after year thinking about the same exact problem, but also waiting 7 years for his result to be proven is nearly unimaginable. He was resilient even through extremely difficult times. And due to his diligent efforts, he was instantly recognized on a worldwide scale. One of his biggest lifelong dreams became a reality when he was announced as a recipient of the Nobel Prize. But back to the question, how exactly smart was Einstein? Well, think of it this way, it certainly took a very intelligent man to discover the theory of general relativity, amongst many other concepts. But his intelligence would have basically gone to waste had Einstein given up anywhere during his journey. Giving up was simply not a part of his vocabulary. That being said, being mistaken for having a learning disability. Then going on to being globally praised for allowing us to have a much greater understanding of the universe has always been almost unheard of. One can argue that his genius stems from his desire to self-learn and improve, his insane dedication to his field, or both.